Hypertensive encephalopathy. The term hypertensive encephalopathy refers to the presence of signs or symptoms of cerebral edema produced by significant and abrupt increases in blood pressure. It is mainly an exclusion diagnosis when other causes of central nervous system dysfunction have been ruled out, and it often responds significantly to abrupt reduction of mean arterial pressure, sometimes by as little as 10% to 15%. In normal autoregulation, when blood pressure rises mildly to moderately, the first reaction is arterial and arteriolar vasoconstriction. This autoregulatory mechanism keeps tissue perfusion at a generally constant level while also preventing pressure increases from being transferred to smaller, more distant arteries. Autoregulation, on the other hand, ultimately fails with growing severity of hypertension. The resulting increase in pressure in the arterioles and capillaries causes acute vascular wall injury. When the vascular endothelium is disrupted, plasma components, including fibrinoid material, penetrate the vascular wall, restricting or obliterating the vascular lumen. Within the brain, the failure of autoregulation causes breakthrough vasodilation, which leads to cerebral edema and the clinical presentation of hypertensive encephalopathy. The degree of fibrinoid necrosis is determined by the chronic baseline blood pressure, prior to the substantial increase in BP. Chronic hypertension patients have arteriolar hypertrophy, which reduces pressure transfer to the capillary circulation. In previously normotensive patients with acute hypertension due to preeclampsia or acute glomerulonephritis, hypertensive encephalopathy can be seen at diastolic pressures as low as 100 mm of mercury. Patients with impaired autoregulation may also develop hypertensive injury at relatively mild levels of hypertension. Autoregulation not only protects tissues from the consequences of severe hypertension, but it also maintains tissue perfusion during hypertension therapy through arterial and arteriolar vasodilation. An excessive hypotensive response below the autoregulatory range, on the other hand, may result in ischemia symptoms. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.